Clark's keys. In a curt, crisp cadence, Clark Corcoran called out to Carrie, his wife. "Seen my keys?" Carrie quickly came back. "Calm down, Clark. Where do you keep your keys?" "Come on. If I knew where I kept my keys, I wouldn't be questioning." "Was wondering," she said. "Was work when you had the keys last?" "In the car," Clark commented, "when I went to the quick check to get the cabbage and the Cabernet." "What a klutz, Clark," Carrie cried. "I can't comprehend your constant confusion." Carrie's comment was like a kick in the keister. Normally kind and cute, Carrie usually gave him kudos up the kazoo and crowned him king of her castle. But now, in contrast, her candor curbed his confidence. The comfort changed to criticism. "Cut the clever crap and control your karma, Carrie," Clark declared. "I'm kidding, Clark. I care. I'm your companion. Can the criticism. You have my consolation and comfort," Carrie concluded. "You're too kind to be a creep." He climbed the staircase to the second floor. Though he saw some candy in a can, couldn't find keys for the car. Clark concentrated on these concerns. Could a common crook have carried away the keys? It's commonplace for kooks to come to our community. Could have been a criminal, copy my keys in a caper. Contemplating these uncomfortable concepts made Carl cringe. The thought crawled through his nervous system like a horseshoe crab. He clambered to the cellar and collided with the curious cat. "Careful, kitty," he exclaimed. "Can't find keys here, even in the commode." Clark started sneezing. Snot soared and silently scattered on the stairs like snowflakes as he stepped. He picked a piece of tissue paper from a package in his pocket. He felt something hard. Hurriedly, his hand reached, and he recognized the ring, a reminder the last time he had retained that remnant in his trouser receptacle. The keys were in his khakis all along. Case closed.